Hi everyone, welcome to JavaTechie. So in this tutorial, we'll understand how to perform centralized logging in microservice architecture using ELK Stack. Okay, so before we start our development, let's have some basic knowledge about what exactly this ELK and its architecture. So what is ELK? ELK stands for E for Elasticsearch, L for Logstash and K for Kibana. Basically, to perform this centralized logging mechanism in microservice architecture, we need to integrate these three components, Elasticsearch, Logstash and Kibana. So first, we should know roles or purpose of each component, right? So the first component is Elasticsearch. Basically, Elasticsearch is a NoSQL database that is based on the Lucene search engine, which will help us to store the data. Okay. Then the next component is Logstash. So basically, Logstash is a log pipeline tool that accepts inputs or logs from various sources and exports the logs or data to various target. Okay. So the last component is Kibana. Basically, Kibana is used for visualization purpose, which will help developer to monitor their application log from the user interface. So the purpose of using each component, so Elasticsearch will help us to store the data, Logstash will help us to process the data, and Kibana will help us to view those data. So let's understand this three component integration at high level. So once we generate log file of our application, that log file we need to give to this Logstash. So Logstash will read those log file and he will send to this Elasticsearch. As we understand, Elasticsearch is a NoSQL DB. Elasticsearch will store those log data. Then Kibana will keep on pulling from this Elasticsearch those log data to display in user interface. Okay. So Logstash will process the data and Elasticsearch will store those data and Kibana will keep on pulling from Elasticsearch to visualize those data in user interface. Okay. So in this tutorial, we'll create one Spring Boot project. Then we'll generate log file of that Spring Boot application. Then we'll give that log file to Logstash. So I will show you that configuration, how we can give our log file to Logstash. Then this Logstash will send those data to Elasticsearch. Even I will show you how those data will be documented in Elasticsearch NoSQL DB. Then we'll understand how this log data from Elasticsearch will send to Kibana. Okay. How can we see the same Spring Boot log in our Kibana dashboard? I will show you all the required configuration to perform this centralized logging mechanism in microservice architecture. So let's understand this scenario in action. Let's get started. So as we understand, this Elasticsearch, Logstash and Kibana, these three are different components. First, we need to download these three components. Okay. So you can go to this elastic.co/downloads. Then you can download Elasticsearch. Then you can download Kibana and also you can download the Logstash. So I will add this download link in video description so that you guys can refer it. Okay. So already I downloaded all these three components. So I'll show you that. So I downloaded and I extracted these three. Now let's go to this Elasticsearch. If you'll go inside this bin, you will find the batch file called elasticsearch.batch. Okay. So we just need to run that. Type command here. Then I'll run elasticsearch.batch. So it will take a couple of seconds to up the Elasticsearch NoSQL database. Then meanwhile, I can go to this Kibana one, so ELK, go to this Kibana, go to the bin. But before you start Kibana, first you need to go to the Kibana config, and if you will open the kibana.yml file, and if you will come down, this elasticsearch.host http localhost 9200, this line we need to uncomment, because we need to inform to Kibana where is my Elasticsearch is up and running, right? That's what we understand in our architecture. So if you'll go to this presentation, Kibana need to talk to the Elasticsearch to fetch all the logs or all the data, right? So that's why Kibana should know where is my Elasticsearch is up and running. That's how we configured in our kibana.yml file. Now what we can do, let me save this. Now go to the Kibana folder and go to the bin Now type command here and run the kibana.batch file. Enter it. Meanwhile, I guess our Elasticsearch is up. Yeah. So if you observe, it started. So to verify that, let's go to the browser. As Elasticsearch is running on default port, which is 9200, type localhost. Then type 9200. Yeah, so let me zoom it. We can see this response, right? Cluster name, then the version of Elasticsearch and few information about Elasticsearch. Okay. So next what we can do, let's verify our Kibana console. So you can see here, Kibana is also up on port 5601. Now go to the browser. Type localhost 5601. Enter it. We can see the Kibana dashboard. So it may take some second to load the page. Yeah, so we can see this Kibana dashboard, right? So we started our Elasticsearch server and we started our Kibana console. Now if you'll go to this architecture, we need to create one Spring Boot project. Then we need to generate a log file. Then we need to give that log file to this Logstash and rest these two server we started. So let's begin with this Spring Boot project. So already I created one Spring Boot sample project. So I created one class called user with two field, ID and name. Then I created one controller class. So I just wrote one method who will return me this four list object of user. Then from controller, based on the ID, I want to fetch the user from that list. Okay. So this is the simple code. There is nothing fancy here. So I get the list of user object. Now based on the ID, I want to fetch the user object. If there is no user object present with this ID, I just want to return null. If user not null, then return me the user and I just want to print that user in log file. If user is getting null, I want to throw some exception and I want to print it. I added this try catch to show you the error as well as the success result in the Kibana console. Okay. So this is the very simple logic. I will add this source code in video description. You guys can download it. Okay. All right. Now let's generate log file of this application. So go to the project. So we added the log statement of the success and as well as for failure, but we need to generate a log file so that we can give that log file to Logstash. So what I can do, go to this application.yml and type here logging, then specify the file and I just want to give some file path. Okay, so what I will do, I created one folder called logs. So let me copy this path. Now go to the code. I just want to give the name of my log file, ELK Stack log. Okay. ELK Stack dot log file. With this ELK slash stack dot log file, I want to generate my log file from this Spring Boot application. So what I will do, I will just start this application. I just want to show you whether we can able to generate a log file or not. Then we will configure our Logstash. So let's wait this application to up. Yeah, so it started now. Now let me copy this URL, get user, and the port is 9898. Now go to the browser. So I will type here localhost 9898 slash get user slash 1. Yeah, so we can see the record with the ID 1. So let's try for the ID 4. We can see the record. Now if I will give the ID as 3, or something which is not present in my user 13, we are getting the empty object. But if you'll go to the console, we can see this exception with the error message, user not found with the ID 13. Now let's verify whether this log is generated or not. So what I can do, go to this folder. Yeah, there is a log file with the same name, elk-stack. Now let me open this log file. We can see this, right? This is the success result and this is the failure. user not found with ID 13. So what I will do, I will just clear this log file. Now we just need to configure the Logstash. Then whatever the log will be generated to this specific log file, that entire log I want to push to this Logstash. So that's why first I clear it, save it. Now let me stop my application. Yeah. So what we can do, let's go to the Logstash folder. Now go to the ELK where you downloaded your Logstash, go to that, then go to the bin. So you can find here there is a Logstash Windows batch file, but we need to tell to Logstash, here is my log file, please read that file and process it. How we can do that? So if you will go to this Logstash documentation, so where, yeah, this one, they provided the step. First download the Logstash and unzip it. Now prepare a logstash.conf file. Okay, inside that conf file you need to tell to Logstash where is your log file located. So what we can do, let me create a file, logstash.conf. So already I have that file, let me show you. I created this log file, logstash.conf file. Here the input, you need to give your path of your log file. Okay, so the path of our log file is, so better let me copy this from our application itself. So just give the path of your log file so that Logstash can read all the data from this specific log file and start position beginning from index 0 or from start of my log, I want to read entire log, then this is the input and output. Even if you want, you can add the filter. Let's say you have 100 lines of log and you want to filter or you want to view some specific log. Okay, so for that you can add the filter here. So if you will go to this config file example, here you can find the step to define your logstash.conf file. Okay, so as of now we'll just add input and output. Now if you observe from Elasticsearch, means from logstash.conf file, at the output section we are giving this to Elasticsearch. As you understand, if you will go to the architecture, this log file we are giving to this Logstash, and this Logstash will push all the log to Elasticsearch NoSQL DB, right? So that's what we are giving, log file to Logstash, and Logstash will push all the log data to Elasticsearch. That's why we mention the host, localhost 9200. So where is my Elasticsearch is up and running, we need to give to this Logstash so that Logstash can push your all log data to this Elasticsearch NoSQL DB. Now let me save this file, and also we'll replace this backward slash with forward slash. So let me change that. Yeah. Now let's mention the same pattern in our application.yml file for logging. Fine. Now save it. So we added the logstash.conf file, right? So let's copy this conf file in our bin folder. So what I'll do, I'll just go to the desktop where we saved it. I'll just copy this, then go to the bin of Logstash and paste it. Fine. Now type the command here and run the logstash.batch file. Okay. So Logstash, then give the file name, which is logstash.conf, right? Now enter. So it will take couple of minutes to up the Logstash server. Yeah, so you can see here our Logstash is up on port 9600. Now what we can do, let's try to hit our API. Okay, so go to the browser and let me type your localhost 9898, then get user slash 3. Okay, we didn't start our server, right? So let me start our application. So wait it to complete. Yeah, so our application started now. Now let's go to the browser and refresh this. We got the response, right? Let's try with one more ID. Let's say 4. We got this result, right? ID and name. Now let's try with some invalid ID. I'll give 44. We'll get the empty user object. But if you'll go to our console, we saw the log error message, right? User not found with ID this. Now if you'll go to your log file, we can see this message, right? One error log and two success log. So now if you'll go to your Logstash console, you can see these logs, right, with the timestamp. And this is what the path we given, elkstack.log. And if you'll come down, it is showing here the Tomcat is started on port 9898. Then we can see the result which we tried. So yeah, user found with ID 3, ID 4 and 1 with the error. User not found with ID 44. So what we can do, let's try 2-3 times more. And let me try with some valid ID 1. Let me try with 2. Yeah. Now let's go back again to our Logstash. Yeah. So we can see the result here, right? User found with user ID 2 and 1. Then we tried 2-3 times with the exception. We got this message. Means these are the log is printing to Logstash, right? So what we can do now? Let's go to the browser and type here localhost 9200. Let's verify our indexes. Okay, type cat. You can find indices. Now just type it. So these are the index internally created by ELK. So for our logging purpose, this Logstash with the current timestamp was created by Logstash itself. Okay. So this content we can view in our Kibana console. So what we can do, let's copy this. Let's do it here only. Give this index, then search it. These are the logs, right? Now what we can do, let's go to the Kibana and let's create the index pattern with the same index. Okay, so our index is this guy, which was internally created by Logstash. If you want to create your own index, what you need to do, you just need to change in your logstash.conf file. I will just add index, then you can give the index name here. Suppose I want to give Logstash or any name, demo, we can specify here. Okay, so let me save it. So now let's go to the Kibana console and let's create the index pattern. So let's go to this management, click on this, create one index pattern, click on this create index pattern. Here just give Logstash. You will find your Logstash current timestamp index. Okay, so click on next step. So if you want, you can use the timestamp. So for this example, I just enable this, means I don't want to use this time filter. Now create index pattern. Yeah, so it created the index pattern. Now we can see all our logs in this Kibana console. So click on this first one, which is discover. And here we can see our index pattern, right? Logstash, which is recently we created. And this Logstash pattern will point to this particular index. So all the data, all the log from this index will be displayed in this Logstash or this Kibana console. So how to verify that? Let me search with ID 44, which we tried. You can see here. User not found with ID 44. Again, we tried for that. And also we can search with the user. Yeah, user ID 3. This is the guy. And for other user also we can search. Let me search with the guy, Mac. Yeah. So this is what we did for the one microservices. Similar way, if you have multiple microservices, we can integrate the log with this Logstash. The same way we need to do for multiple microservices. Just let me know in comment section if you want me to integrate these ELK things in our microservices series. And also let me know in comment section if you want me to show a demo of custom index pattern. Okay, means instead of using this default index given by the Logstash, if you want me to add my own index, I can prepare the demo for that as well. Okay, so this is how we can play with ELK Stack to centralize logging in our microservice architecture. Here in this Kibana console, you can see all the logs. Okay, so you can see here the total hit count 50 hits. Yeah, this is how we can play with this ELK Stack. That's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.